Today we will start with thermodynamics. Now let us first understand what do we mean by a system. So any part of universe which is under thermodynamic consideration is known as system. मान लीजिए अगर हम एक टेस्ट ट्यूब में रिएक्शन कर रहे हैं तो टेस्ट ट्यूब हमारा सिस्टम है क्योंकि हम उसके अंदर जो रिएक्शन हो रहा है उसको स्टडी कर रहे हैं और टेस्ट ट्यूब को छोड़ के जितना भी पार्ट है उसको हम कहते हैं सराउंडिंग्स. तो सराउंडिंग्स क्या है? सिस्टम को छोड़ के जितना भी पार्ट है वो है सराउंडिंग्स. सो दैट मीन्स सिस्टम प्लस सराउंडिंग्स इज इक्वल टू यूनिवर्स. नाउ लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ सिस्टम एंड व्हाट टाइप ऑफ इंटरैक्शन इज पॉसिबल between system and surroundings. First type of system is open system. Now what type of interaction is possible? या तो system surroundings के साथ matter को exchange कर सकता है या फिर वो energy को exchange कर सकता है. Now what is an open system? A system which can exchange both matter and energy with surroundings, that is known as open system. For example, अगर मैं एक ओपन वेसल में चाय को रखूंगी तो वाटर वेपर भी बाहर जा रहा है और थोड़ी देर के बाद चाय ठंडी भी हो जाएगी. दैट मीन्स मैटर और एनर्जी दोनों का एक्सचेंज हो गया है बिटवीन द सिस्टम एंड द सराउंडिंग्स. नाउ व्हाट इज अ क्लोज सिस्टम? अगर हम किसी क्लोज वेसल में चाय लेते हैं तो व्हाट विल हैपन? और हमने उसको ऊपर से बंद कर दिया तो हम देखेंगे कि वाटर ड्रॉपलेट्स जो है वो लिड जो हमने उसका जिससे क्लोज किया उसके अंदर कंडेंस हो गए हैं. तो इसका मतलब वाटर वेपर तो एस्केप नहीं कर पाया लेकिन थोड़ी देर के बाद चाय ठंडी हो जाएगी, इंडिकेटिंग दैट एक्सचेंज ऑफ एनर्जी हैज़ टेकन प्लेस बट मैटर हैज़ नॉट बीन एक्सचेंज. सो दैट मीन्स मैटर एक्सचेंज नहीं हो पाया, एनर्जी एक्सचेंज हो गई. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम. आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम क्या है? जिसमें कि ना तो मैटर एक्सचेंज हो सकता है और ना ही एनर्जी एक्सचेंज हो सकती है. अगर मैं चाय को किसी थर्मस फ्लास्क में ले लेती हूँ तो ऐसा तो है नहीं कि कभी ठंडी नहीं होगी, लेकिन हम ये मान के चलते हैं दैट इट हैज़ इंसुलेटेड वॉल्स सो इट विल नॉट अलाउ द हीट टू एस्केप आउट, इंडिकेटिंग नाउ दैट आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम कैन नॉट एक्सचेंज मैटर and it also cannot exchange energy. Now what do we mean by state of a system? अब मैं आपको कोई गैस देती हूँ और मैं आपसे कहती हूँ कि आप इस गैस को डिस्क्राइब करो, तो आप उस गैस को कैसे डिस्क्राइब करोगे? इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रेशर, वॉल्यूम, टेम्परेचर. सो दीज थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज दे आर नोन एज स्टेट वेरिएबल्स विच डिस्क्राइब द स्टेट ऑफ अ सिस्टम. जब तक ये प्रॉपर्टीज़ कांस्टेंट रहेंगी हम बोलेंगे दैट द सिस्टम इज़ इन थर्मोडायनेमिक इक्विलिब्रियम. लेकिन अगर एनी ऑफ दीज प्रॉपर्टीज़ विल चेंज वी विल से दैट अ प्रोसेस हैज़ टेकन प्लेस. नाउ व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड बाय स्टेट फंक्शन? अभी आगे हम बहुत बार इस टर्म को यूज़ करेंगे कि स्टेट फंक्शन क्या है. तो एनी थर्मोडायनेमिक क्वांटिटी विच डिपेंड्स ओनली ऑन द इनिशियल स्टेट एंड फाइनल स्टेट एंड डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द पाथ फॉलोड टू अटेन दैट स्टेट इज नोन एज अ स्टेट फंक्शन. फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर मैं किसी स्टोन को रूफ के ऊपर रख देती हूँ तो चाहे मैं उस स्टोन को स्टेयर से लेके जाऊँ, चाहे मैं उस स्टोन को लिफ्ट से लेके जाऊँ, लेकिन उसकी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी विल रिमेन द सेम. अगर मैं किसी वेसल को लेती हूँ और उसके अंदर पानी डालती हूँ, अगर मैंने वो वाटर रेन वाटर से डाला या टैप वाटर से डाला तो जो वॉल्यूम है वो सिर्फ इनिशियल स्टेट और फाइनल स्टेट पर डिपेंड कर रही है. इट विल नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द पाथ बाय विच आई हैव टेकन दैट वाटर इन द वेसल, इंडिकेटिंग दैट वॉल्यूम इज अ स्टेट फंक्शन. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट वर्क डन. नाउ वर्क डन में अगर हम स्टेयर से ऊपर जा रहे हैं या हम लिफ्ट से ऊपर जा रहे हैं तो व्हाट विल हैपन? अगर मैं लिफ्ट से ऊपर जाऊंगी वर्क डन वुड बी लेस, लेकिन अगर मैं स्टेयर से जाऊंगी वर्क डन वुड बी मोर. What does this indicate? That work depends upon the path followed, which means that work is a path function and it is not a state function. Now let us discuss various processes that take place in thermodynamics. Now, first is isothermal process. Isothermal process mein kya hota hai? That temperature is constant. That means delta T throughout the process, it would be zero because temperature change hi nahi hua. So T1 would be equal to T2, indicating that delta T is equal to zero. Now, what is isochoric process? Isochoric process is in which volume is constant throughout, indicating that delta V is equal to zero. What is isobaric process? Isobaric process is in which pressure is constant, indicating that delta P is equal to zero. Now, what is adiabatic process? Adiabatic process is in which the amount of heat entering or leaving the system is constant. That means delta Q is equal to zero. Now, what is the difference between isothermal process and adiabatic process? Isothermal mein kya ho raha hai ki jitni heat system ke andar enter kar rahi hai, utni hi heat system se leave kar rahi hai. So temperature is constant. Now, what does adiabatic process mean? That no heat can enter or leave the system. जितनी हीट सिस्टम के अंदर है उतनी ही रहेगी, क्योंकि हमारी जो वॉल्स हैं दे आर इंसुलेटेड, दे विल नॉट अलाउ द हीट टू एंटर और लीव द सिस्टम. नाउ व्हाट इज अ रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस? सो अ प्रोसेस विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस इनफाइनाइटिसिमली स्लोली सो दैट सिस्टम एंड surroundings are in equilibrium at every stage. That process is known as a reversible process. All the steps which are taking place in the forward direction can be exactly reversed in a reversible process. Now, what is an irreversible process? Irreversible process is which cannot be reversed. And during the process, system and surroundings are not in equilibrium. So, all the thermodynamically spontaneous processes are irreversible in nature. Internal energy is represented by U or E. Now, what is internal energy? It is the total energy which is stored in a system. So, it is a sum of different kinds of energies, electronic energy, nuclear energy, potential energy, kinetic energy. Now, kinetic energy is again a sum of translational energy, vibrational energy and rotational energy. Now, internal energy ki absolute value U ko hum measure nahi kar sakte. Hum sirf delta U ko measure kar sakte hain, which is U2 minus U1. Now, why we cannot measure the absolute value of U? Because it is a sum of many different kinds of energies, some of which cannot be accurately measured, jiski wajah se absolute value of U cannot be measured, only delta U can be measured. Now delta U or internal energy, it is a state function. It is a state function, that means its value depends only on the initial state and final state. Now, what is the sign convention that we use for delta U? If energy is released, agar energy release ho rahi hai, to hum bolenge that delta U is negative. And if energy is absorbed, what we will say? We will say that delta U is positive. Now, internal energy is a function of temperature. So, what does this mean? अगर हम isothermal process की बात कर रहे हैं, तो for isothermal process, what will happen? For isothermal process, since T is constant, और मैं कह रही हूँ कि internal energy डेल्टा टी जीरो है फॉर आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस, और मैं आपको ये बोल रही हूँ कि इंटरनल एनर्जी डिपेंड्स ऑन टेम्परेचर, इसका मतलब अगर टेम्परेचर चेंज नहीं हो रहा तो फॉर आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस डेल्टा यू विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द नेक्स्ट टर्म, दैट इज हीट. हीट इज अगेन अ फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी दैट इज एक्सचेंज बिटवीन सिस्टम एंड सराउंडिंग्स. नाउ what is the sign convention for heat? If heat is released, so we will say that Q is negative, and if heat is absorbed, we will say that Q is positive. Now what are the units of heat? We say calorie or joule, and 1 calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. So this is the sign convention for heat. Now what is work done? Now again, work done ki sign convention kya hoti hai? If work is done by the system, work is done by the system, to hum bolenge that it is W is negative, and if work is done on the system, that means W is positive. Now, what are the two different types of work that are possible? One is electrical work done. Which is equal to EMF into quantity of electricity. And the other is pressure volume work, which we will study in detail. Pressure volume work or PV work. Now, let us study about the work done in irreversible expansion. Now let us consider that we have taken gas in a cylinder and we have fitted it with a piston. Now if P external is less than the pressure of gas, that means pressure of gas is greater, what will happen? Expansion takes place, and when expansion takes place, iska matlab kya hoga? That work is done by the gas, iska matlab kya hai? Ki work done has to be negative. So by sign convention we will take the work done to be negative. Now, when the gas expands, the piston will move, and when it moves, let us say that dW is the small amount of work that is done. Now, when the piston moves, it will do some work, and we say that what is work done? It is the force into displacement. Now, let us assume that when it is moving, it is doing this small work dW and it has moved a distance dL. Now force is equal to pressure into area. So that means we will say that P into A into dL, and area into dL will be equal to dV, that is volume. So dW is equal to P into dV, and if we want to find out the total work done, we will have to integrate it from V1 to V2 at constant pressure, and we will get, now this is the external pressure, so P external V2 minus V1, or P external into delta V. Now, since I told you that work done of expansion is negative, so we will put a negative sign here, and this is the formula that you are going to use in the numericals for calculating the work done. Now suppose aapko volume is given in liter or it is given in milliliter and external pressure is given in atmosphere. But the work done you have to calculate in joules. So you will apply the relationship 1 liter atmosphere is equal to 101.3 joules for doing this conversion. Now this was the work done in irreversible expansion. Now work done in isothermal reversible expansion of a gas. Now when will a reversible process take place? When there is a infinitesimally small difference between the external pressure and the internal pressure. Iska matlab P external will be smaller than P internal by a pressure dP, by small amount dP, because there has to be an infinitesimally small difference between the external pressure and internal pressure for reversible expansion to take place. Now, if we want to find out the work done, we will apply the formula minus P external dV. Now, if we apply the formula for P external dV, it would be now, since dP and dV, they are very small quantities, so we can ignore them, क्योंकि जब हम उनको multiply करेंगे, dP into dV करेंगे, तो वो और ज़्यादा small हो जाएगी. So, we are left with the small amount of work done, dW is equal to minus P internal dV. Now, if we say that the gas is ideal, तो P internal will become equal to nRT by V. So we substitute it here, nRT by V dV. Now we will integrate it in order to find out the total work done. So that means integral of dW is equal to nRT ko hum common le lenge, dV by V, and we will integrate it from V1 to V2. So we will get work done is equal to minus nRT ln V2 by V1, and if we change it to log to the base 10, we get minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1, and since pressure is inversely proportional to volume, in terms of pressure, the formula will become nRT log P1 by P2. So these are the two formulas, this and this, which you are going to use in the numericals. Agar aapko initial pressure or final pressure given hai, to aap ye formula use karoge. Aur agar aapko initial volume or final volume given hai, to aap ye formula use karoge. But one thing you will keep in mind, that R ki value will be 8.314 joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse. So that the work done comes out to be in joule. Now we will understand the first law of thermodynamics. Now we will talk about the first law of thermodynamics. Now you all know the law of conservation of energy. It says that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be converted from one form to another. So, if I provide a heat 1 calorie, work done would be 4.184 joules. So, on providing a heat equal to 1 calorie, I am getting work done 4.184 joules. So, there is an exact equivalence between the heat given and the work produced. Now we can also state it as we cannot construct a perpetual motion machine which can completely convert all the heat into work without leaving the effect somewhere else. Now how do we derive this first law of thermodynamics? Now let us consider a system whose initial internal energy is U1. Now let us supply a Q amount of heat to it and let the work done be W, and let the final internal energy be equal to U2. Now U2 minus U1 is equal to Q plus W. That means delta U is equal to Q plus W, which is the mathematical formulation for first law of thermodynamics. And if I put W equal to minus P delta V, so it becomes delta U plus P delta V is equal to Q. Now, what is zeroth law of thermodynamics? So, zeroth law of thermodynamics says that if a body A is in equilibrium with a body B, and A is also in equilibrium with a body C, then B is also in equilibrium with C. Now, let us talk about what is a cyclic process. Cyclic process is a process in which when we start with some initial state, after the process we reach to the original state from where we started. Now for this cyclic process, delta U is equal to 0, delta H is equal to 0, delta H is enthalpy change which we will talk about, and delta S is also equal to 0, delta S is entropy change which we will talk about. Now, if we plot a graph here, pressure volume, so we will see that how the curves are coming. This is the first step, this is the second step, third step, and fourth step. Now, what is one? One is isothermal expansion. Two is adiabatic expansion. Third step is isothermal compression. And the fourth step is adiabatic expansion. So when we carry out these four steps, we get delta U equal to 0, delta H equal to 0, delta S equal to 0. So this is a cyclic process. Now let us understand what is enthalpy. Enthalpy is represented by H. Now what is enthalpy? It is the heat content of the system. इंटरनल एनर्जी हमने पढ़ा कि क्या था, इट इज़ द टोटल एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन अ सिस्टम. तो उस टोटल एनर्जी में से जितनी एनर्जी को हम हीट में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं, दैट इज़ नोन एज एंथैल्पी ऑफ द सिस्टम. नाउ एच इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस पी वी, दैट मीन्स डेल्टा एच इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा यू प्लस पी डेल्टा वी. नाउ इफ आई हैव टू डिराइव अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन delta H and delta U. Now delta H is equal to delta U plus P V2 minus P V1. P V2 minus V1. Now P V2 is equal to N2 RT for an ideal gas, and P V1 is equal to N1 RT. If I apply the ideal gas equation, after substituting it here, I get N2 minus N1 RT. So it becomes delta H is equal to delta U plus delta n g r t, where n2 is equal to number of moles of gaseous products and n1 is equal to number of moles of gaseous reactants. Now let us study the conditions under which delta H will become equal to delta U. Now what is the first condition? If I say that the reaction is taking place at constant volume, what will happen at constant volume? Delta V will become equal to 0. So that means if delta V becomes equal to 0 and I say that delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V, so delta H will become equal to delta U. Now if N2 is equal to N1, that is number of moles of products is equal to number of moles of gaseous reactants. मतलब कि equation के अंदर जितने gaseous reactants हैं उतने ही gaseous products भी हैं, तो इसका मतलब again delta Ng will become equal to 0. Here we have 2 moles of gaseous reactants, 2 moles of gaseous products, so that means delta Ng will be 0. If it does not involve any gaseous reactant or product, again delta Ng will be 0. If there is no gaseous reactant or product in the equation, again delta Ng will be 0. So that means if I take this equation which does not involve any gaseous reactant or product, then again delta Ng is 0 and delta H will become equal to delta U. Now we will study about the heat capacity. What is heat capacity? It is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of any amount of substance by 1 degree Celsius. Now what is the formula of heat capacity? It is dq by dt, or we can say that it is q by delta t. dq by dt is when we talk about very small amount, otherwise the formula is q by delta t. Now if I say specific heat capacity. Now for specific heat capacity, what is the definition? It is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. Now here I have specified that what is the amount of substance. So now specific heat capacity is equal to Q upon M into delta T. I have specified the mass here. Now what is molar heat capacity? Molar heat capacity is Q by N delta T. So it is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. So here I have specified the number of moles. Now what is an extensive property? Property which depends on the amount of substance contained in the system, that is, it depends upon the mass. Now let us consider 1 liter of water taken in a vessel and 1 milliliter of water taken in a vessel. Obviously the volume is going to depend upon the mass which I have taken. Now that means mass, volume and heat capacity, they depend upon the mass. Heat capacity is going to change for a particular mass because I have not specified कि मैं कितना मास ले रही हूँ, इट इज एनी अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस. नाउ व्हाट इज एन इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी? इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टी इज विच डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द mass of the substance or amount of substance taken, but it depends only upon the nature of the substance. That means specific heat capacity is an intensive property, because now I have specified ki it is for 1 gram of the substance. So specific heat capacity is intensive. Now what does this mean? That when I divide two extensive properties, I get intensive property. So that means when I will divide mass and volume, I will get density, which is intensive. When I divide heat capacity by mole, I get molar heat capacity, which is intensive. Now today we have studied about different types of systems, we have studied about the different terms which we are using in thermodynamics, and we have studied about the laws of thermodynamics, that is zeroth law and the first law. Questions related to these concepts and numericals related to the work done are given in the module. On applying these concepts, your concept will become more clear. Thank you. God bless you.